Hey everybody, it's CJ Miller. I'm in Shreveport, Louisiana. I'm across the Red River from beautiful Bossier City, Louisiana. As always, I want to invite you to come check us out on your summer vacation, your road trips, or whatever. We're great for that. Just getting away, doing something different. And if we're not your destination, but you're passing through, we're a hell of a layover, you know. And if you don't believe me, when you get here, look me up. We'll figure something out. So, you know, as I'm painting on this canvas, I did forewarn that I do a lot of videos because it's part of my creative process. What happens when I look at a canvas like this that I'm working on, and I look at it through the lens of a digital representation, is that it gives me an outside perspective that's outside of the eye of the creator, you know. So that's one of the reasons why I do so many videos about it, but also just kind of like lets me know where I go, kind of informs my philosophy about where the philosophy is coming in at. And today it's right in this area, because this is something that I put on canvas, and it was just a building, and then I put some swirls on it just to break up a solid. And then as it dried and I came back to it, it's like, you know, I really think that that kind of reminds me of this building that we have with the large mural on the side of it downtown. So I decided to allow that to be, you know. And then, so I'm going to talk about some subtle changes and some not so subtle changes that I made this evening. The first thing is, behind this, I started with kind of a blocking yellow and an ivory black together to create you know, kind of some shapes that I wanted to work with. And then one of the things that I did was I kind of put these little beacons that top some of the buildings, and I almost feel like I did too much there, but I'll leave it, whatever. But I put some here too, and it was too much too close together, you know, the little red little beacons that maybe signal to like low-flying aircraft, helicopters, or whatever, that we have buildings here. Don't fly too low with it. So I worked on changing it up. So here, because this was all like one structure in different shapes, but what I did was I kind of like kind of forced a smear. I didn't mind it. I was like, it's a good color, and I want to use it, and I want to implement it. And so I'm going to let it be some atmosphere that's kind of building in the back. I'll let it play with that atmosphere, which is, it's okay, because it kind of gives a little bit of a shadow to in the back of what's going on. But maybe that's going to kind of build into like a cloud or a fog bank or something that we're working on here. Right over where the river would be that we're not quite looking at. So from that, what I did was I just took the same black and yellow. And kind of when you get in here, you can see the brush strokes. When you get real close up on it, it's like, oh my God, that's scribble. It's a smear. It's like, looks like, you know, like a 2-year-old finger painting or something. But when you pull back, you kind of get a little, you kind of get an image of, okay, well, this is a building, and it's a, you know, we're seeing two sides of this building, you know, coming out this way, and then a longer a facade of it here, and the yellow would be like kind of like the rows of windows and everything in a very low definition kind of sense. And then behind it, we have a building. Now, depending upon where your eye gives you, you know, this could be a billboard signage, or it could still be a mural. To me, it still looks like a building with a mural painted on the side of it, just in front of the other. And even in that distance, as they kind of blend, that's okay, because I've already decided I'm going to work around like some atmosphere that's kind of wrap around some of all this once it's all done. So there'll be like bits of steam and fog and atmosphere coming up through the buildings. It's going to be so cool. If it works out the way I want it to, with the mirrored building here, this is the only one I really kind of want some of that blue canvas peeking through, because I want it to look like reflection of, you know, but you know, it's I'm having fun with this. The philosophy that I've got with this is like, because I did this change in there, it's like, you know, that's kind of like, you know, what we do on our daily basis. You know, we have to, as we're painting, with especially wet on wet, if you do something and then you're like, you know, I'm not really digging that and you need to change it. Or even if you just accidentally touch your brush down in the wrong spot or something and it becomes smudged or something, you just kind of work that into the narrative of what you're creating with your artwork. You know, and so this is going to be great. This is going to be great. I'm really enjoying all this. So now I'm loving the way this really has dried. And as it's dried, the lines that I put here to be like the bay door of this temporary building and the vent and stuff, you know, those lines have, to me, now that they're dry, they look bolder, more crisp than what they were, I think, when I first put them down. So that's working. Okay, so one of the things I just got in here and I just put like touches of red, just kind of emboldened those reds above this. And this kind of started out being a representation of the Regent's Bank. I feel that it's changed somewhat, and that's okay. That is okay, you know, that it would do that. But you get into it and it's like... I started working on kind of a step down, but I wanted to do it not in a very harsh, I didn't want really harsh lines off in the distance. I wanted a blurriness. And so it was kind of hard to get the tiers, you know, the different tiers of the building as it kind of came down and got a little bit wider each time, you know, so whatever, you know. So next we'll be moving over into this area, and if as I'm working into the center, if I get a little bit less detailed, it's because there's going to be some work in the foremost part of the painting that I'm working on creating this view through a window pane. And atmospheric, you know, weather and everything beyond that, whatever we're going to see. So there's going to be some blurriness, you know. And then whatever we put in the foreground is going to be a lot more crisp. And that's going to create kind of a difference where we're, you know. So that's kind of cool. I have an idea. I just have to work on really creating it. So the detail, the different levels of detail, mean that what happens is that I would change the broadness or the fineness of the brush. You know, I would change the type of brush that I'm using, depending upon the level of details. And the further I get in the distance, the closer, the more fine the brushes has to be. But I actually have to be careful, because with that, and I get way on it, I could get far more detailed, even in the distance, than I am in the middle ground, which would play against the perspective that I want to create. So I want to be careful about that, that I'm observing, you know. And also, now that the steeple, the cross of this church, has firmly dried, I'm really glad that I did just bring that out just a little bit against the atmosphere, because it was like it was fading into the little swivel of cloud behind it. That cross was kind of like folding into that, and it was barely noticeable. I didn't want it to be like overpowering, and I feel that it's not now, especially since I put this darker building, actually two darker buildings back there, and gave it a little bit of balance so that we don't have just a black cross, however fine it might be, but there's a balance to it. And so as we get a little further, I can play with changing a little bit of the tonality as we get farther in the distance, because, I could play with the idea of getting into a different little neighborhood, a different little area of town, a different zone that may have a different appearance. The buildings may look a little different than, so, you know what I mean? In certain neighborhoods. Ziggy, Skit, I don't know why that song's... This will work. So what could happen is that, you know, the image of the structures will change just a little bit as I get into that distance and where we're going, you know. Maybe more shadowed and less detailed, you know, so we'll see fewer representations of archways and windows and things, which, by the way, did I already talk about this? This is our building that had this ghost sign for a long time. You need a biscuit. It was a very historic sign, and it almost faded completely. And then recently, when they bought the sign, they decided to preserve it, that the new owners. So they actually put the sign, a representation of the sign, back up there, even as they put some windows, because they converted it into apartments. So the signage now has black windows, big white bright letters that says, "You need a biscuit, 5 cents for whatever, for per package," or something like that, you know. Very historic. It was one of the first, actually it was the first advertising of its type for a widely produced and marketed food product. You know, and it changed the way soda crackers were sold, because they used to be sold by, you would go in and you would weigh them out like you would penny candy or something like that, and pay by whatever you selected as a pound. But they were pre-measuring mass marketing this thing. It was cool. It was great. It started the National Biscuit Company, which later became Nabisco. And then it also started the National Advertising Company, which I don't know what the hell that – I don't know what that became. But, yeah. But it was specifically for the signage. And then others followed suit. So I'm not sure where the finished look. I know that this a representation of the view that I have out of my window, but it is vastly changed, and that's okay, because as I see it over here, I don't need an exact same that's going to go over there. I just want something to, you kind of fill some space over there. And then from there, I've already got an idea of the curtains that I've got selected that I want to put up. But I have a list of priorities of things that I want to spend money on. Things have to come in their correct order of priorities, as far as like decoration, and all as far as, because my decorating is coming out of my recreational budget, my vacation budget, all that kind of stuff, you know, so it's, you know, miscellaneous, extemporaneous enjoyment spending. It has to be, it has to come more slowly than, of course, what I would like, but whatever. I am having such a good time with this painting. And so if you're watching these videos, thanks. And, I hope they're not too boring for you. If you folks out there do any sort of creativity, music, sculpting, writing, artwork, and there's examples of it online, provided that it's just for the sake of sharing the art, and you're not trying to promote or sell your stuff, I don't mind if you wanted to comment or put links or something like that. I just don't want my channel to be like my YouTube channel. I don't want people to come in and start like promoting the things that they're selling. I'm not looking for sponsors. I wouldn't want to accept money from sponsors, and therefore I don't want other people, you know, making money off of my videos such as they are. I've literally have blocked a couple of people because they were like, promoting stuff, and it's like, no, but this isn't what this is about. The internet is full of people that want to promote the things that they want to sell. If there's anybody going to be promoting anything to sell, it's me. And I'm not doing that currently. If I did, it would be, my prerogative. It's my channel. I don't want someone else doing that. So let's not do that, you know. I hope I said that politely. I hope that doesn't make me seem like a jerk, but that's just not what this channel is about. It's just about, you know, first off, it's about always inviting people to come to North Louis, Louisiana and check us out. And secondly, it's just about sharing thoughts and whatever about what happens in my day-to-day, you know. My personal goals. By the way, I did reach a personal goal today. This is so awesome. That's one of the reasons why I'm so stoked. I totally reached my goal weight. Like actually just a little under. When I weighed in at my gym, I was like right at my goal weight. And then, yeah, so that was great. And of course, I see my doctor in early April. So right now it's just going to be a question of maintenance. I've got about 3 weeks. And so if I could in that 3 weeks lose like one or two more pounds, that would give me just a little bit of a flexibility so that I could be like, hey. Now that's my goal weight, which I set realistic goals. That's one of the things when doing a healthy a healthy lifestyle. Maybe you want to do some dieting, you want to do some gym work, whatever. Remember those small goals, those small obtainable goals, and those little goals obtained one by one, they will get you a lot closer to your further goal. So my ideal weight, I wanted to lose this. Why can't I lose that last 10 pounds? And now that I have, I can maintain that. And then when I get ready to set my next goal, you know, then I can do that. But yeah, I that's cool. Let's take time to celebrate these little goals. They matter, you know. So whatever little goal that you have accomplished, give yourself a big pat on the back and a congratulations for it, you know. Even if it's not about, even if you're not going to sing it out to the world, at least you know that you made those little accomplishments, you know, just a little bit today. Or maybe it was a milestone. Today, for me, it was a milestone. This was like a number. It's not really about the number of the weight. I know. It's more like your body mass index and you know, all that. There's a lot that goes on to physical and emotional health also. But this was a goal that I set and I did reach it and I'm so excited. It's one of the reasons why I'm more like active as I talk about it. Now I'm going to shut up because I feel like I'm on the verge of bragging and I don't want to brag. I was just kind of talking about that, you know. So, yeah, that's cool. So I'm not bragging. I'm actually talking myself into a mentality of maintaining and maybe superseding that expectation by lowering just a couple of pounds so that when I go to see the doctor, he will see that, yes, I did at least get to this and did not totally turn right around and reverse it. You know, I didn't reach my goal and then, okay, great. Now it's safe. I can stop. No, it's, yeah, that's cool. So, and then my actual, ideal weight, is not that far away from my goal weight. I'm one of these kind of people. I kind of have like a small body, you know, like whatever. And, so it's amazing, how just a few pounds can mean diabetic symptoms versus not having diabetic symptoms, you know, with the type 2 diabetes. It's like, it's all it really takes is one more straw on top of the haystack sometimes to push somebody over, and all of a sudden it's like, wow. And then once those little things start, when I started experiencing those diabetic symptoms, firstly the A1C increase, it was like, okay, well, it's just a matter of time before these things start to accumulate against me, so I better get proactive and make the changes that I need to make today. And that was a few years ago. So, you know, thank you for enduring me talking about that. Thank you for enduring me talking about this painting, which, like other goals, I do a little bit at a time. Some people can get a canvas and they can just, you know, color it in a 15-minute afternoon session. I enjoy the thought process as much as I enjoy putting the brush and paint to canvas and creating the look. Oh, I used to love this song, Duran Duran. That's why it's in my playlist. My playlist, I have a lot of stuff that's modern, but I also have a lot of retro-sounding songs, because my playlist, pretty much I create out of what is sentiment, you know, what's attached to a memory or a thought or what makes me feel good. Even the stuff that I listen to that's more modern today usually is attached. There's a story attached to it, and that's why it's in the playlist. Otherwise, I could just turn on, you know, like a, you know, top 100 radio or something and just listen to it, you know. Like, I can just say, give me a top 100 playlist to Ziggy, and he would just play random stuff, and it'd be good. But I like to reflect. Art gives me feelings and enhances my thought, but I'm a weirdo. Hey, I love you guys. Truly, come check us out in Shreveport-Bossier. Love and light, peace, God bless, good night. Don't need to go get a manicure. Bye-bye.